Spring sports are getting off to a harsh start as winter weather takes a hold of precious training time.
The weather has not been, there's been no question about it. It's been really, really cold. So the kids don't, you know, the kids don't want to argue with you about going outside because it's just no use. It's very cold. So I think it's allowed us to bond a little bit, you know, in some of these games that we've been able to play. And
due to inclement weather, practices have been limited to basic workouts that delay team progress.
And a lot of our specialized events, we've been trying to get some conditioning, but on cold days, it's hard to pick up a shot put and a discus. It's hard to pick up a pole and pole vault. It's hard to just get out there and be very focused on specialized skills when you're out there just trying to stay warm.
The challenges in facing such conditions have failed to stop this year's teams from achieving success.
We've kind of just taken advantage of the fact that we are inside to just kind of slow down and focus more on drills and technique work rather than rushing into full-on practice.
We try to always have the best practices we can have to put us in a better situation, you know, to make us better prepared than the people who are in the same predicament we are in. So we always want to show each other that, hey, we're doing things that are putting us at an advantage.
Unfortunately, coaches find it more difficult to expand their teams as their morale is beaten by the cold weather, as well as being confined to indoor areas for practice.
There's so much more encouraging and positive. It makes spirits high, you know, and right now it's just, you gotta motivate people through preseason so they're out of shape. Then you gotta convince them to come out in some 30 degree weather. If we're indoors, we're trying to find some kind of spot. And right now we're all our sports teams are sharing one gym and a few little cubby holes here and there. So it makes it really difficult, but you know, everyone's in the position, I guess. So we'll survive, we'll get through it. Makes this tougher.
From Delaware State News, this is Tori Seagraves.